Yes.
Okay. So Nagarathar timelines, our history for the last 2000 years, we have a short video. So world trade wonder, it is it's there from the day when all ancient civilizations started to happen. So Rome was a very big kingdom, they had surplus money, they were ready to invest in trade. And they were ready to buy goods from, luxury goods from the East. So Rome couldn't directly trade with India or with China. So they had a land route as well as a sea route to trade. Since there was no motorized boats, they could not travel whenever they want or wherever they want. So only in certain months they could travel based on the winds, and they had to stop in a lot of places. So Egypt was right in the center between Rome and India. So this part of land made Rome not to trade with India. So Suez Canal was opened in this place only in 1920s. So before 1920, there couldn't be a direct trade route between Rome and India. So most of the Europeans had to go all the way around Africa to come to India. So this place was of strategical importance. So initially Egypt was ruled by the Ptolemies, and they were separate from the Romans. Cleopatra was the last of the line. So Cleopatra was in love with Caesar. Caesar was killed, and following that, Augustus captured Europe, and Cleopatra came to the Sea. So Egypt came into a direct control of Rome. So Romans could directly trade with Indians without any middlemen. So that meant that every $1 invested, there were $900 written. So there was a booming trade, middlemen were eliminated, and trade in Tamil Nadu need better organization and more traders coming in. So our tradition says that we moved from Naganadu to Kanchipuram. Nobody knows where Naganadu is. Some people believe it is Andhra Pradesh, some people believe it could be Gujarat. Some people believe it is Indus Valley, some people believe it could be somewhere south. So we don't know where Naganadu is. But basically people have moved into Tamil Nadu possibly because of trade reasons. And this could be one of the periods where they could have moved. But there is no historical basis for it. But I have just set this up to explain what is coming up next. So the trade boomed and it needs certain level of organization. So this organization was provided by the kingdoms, especially the Pallava kings. Around 4th century AD, they started dividing their countries into Nadu. Nadu is a local geographical unit of farmlands and craft centers around it. So these farm products and craft products need to be marketed and transferred to traders who are doing international trade, because international trade was giving them multifold returns. So they organized something called Nagarams. Nagarams were mercantile bodies or trade bodies which organized local trade and enabled trading with international traders. So members of this Nagaram were called the Nagarathars, and the Nagaram had responsibility of maintaining the physical properties within the domain of a Nadu, that is usually includes markets and temples. So this is how temple administration was always with the Nagarams, and hence with the Nagarathars. So Nagarathars basically used the temple assets, let it out for rent or for capital turnover, and based on the return of investment or on the rent, they maintained the temple properties. So function of Nagarams is still existing within the Nagarathars, where Nagarathars still take responsibility of lot of temple and its maintenance. So Nagaram just didn't consist of the current day Nagarathar. Current day Nagarathar were general merchants called Chettis. There were other merchants like oil merchants called Vanya Chettiars. Textile merchants called Salia Chettiars. There were even fishmongers and agricultural traders. So all traders formed the Nagaram. So historically our story says that we moved from Naganadu to Kanchipuram, Kanchipuram to Kaveripatnam to Pudukkottai. But our legend attributes very mythical figures of 8,000 years, 5,000 years and so on. So historically we want to validate if this migration was there, and at what period. So what can be done to validate it is that we can map all the Nagaram locations that have been historically validated. So what you see here is that the yellow ones are Pallava period, that is around 4th century to 8th century. So if you see, Kanchipuram was the major, it's around here, Kanchipuram is the major Pallava Nagaram. Then if you see all the green dots, those are the Chola period Nagarams, 8th century to 12th century. You see a big influx of Nagarams in the Kaveri Delta area and Kaveripattinam area. And in the Pandya period, you see new Nagarams sprouting in current Chettinad area and in Tamil Nadu. So historically, we can say that the Nagarams have moved from Kanchipuram then to a major phase in the Chola country around Kaveri Delta and then to the current Puthukottai area, which validates our migration as per our legends. But it doesn't match with respect to years. With respect to years, we have possibly been in Kanchipuram around 4th century, around 6th to 12th century we have been in Kaveri Delta, and around 11th century we have made the migration to the Pandya country. And as late as Vijayanagara period, around 1400 to 1600 AD, this group of traders have fortified to become a trading caste. So why I am saying this is that our general belief is that there is a Natakottai Nagarathar as a caste. Then these people segregated into 9 temples, and these 9 temples segregated into different vagai of people. But historical study doesn't suggest that. Rather, it is inverse. So I'll go through that. So for the trade to happen, I'll take the area here. There is a port here called Tondi, and sea goods from Malaysia come and land here, and from Sri Lanka come and land here. These sea trade goods need to be shipped into the current Chettinad area. So that is a bigger map here. So as soon as the ship lands, there was a toll or cess collected. Why it was collected? Because these areas are notoriously dry lands, so there is no agriculture, so there is higher highway robbery and theft. So they need protection. So the king didn't give the protection, so the protection was given by the trade organization. They had mercenary armies which arranged logistics and would take the trade goods from Tondi to a fortified market. A fortified market means there are a fort within which a market would operate, and it had army to safeguard its goods. So these goods from sea would go into the land into a Erivirapattinam. And there are a lot of local Nagarams. Velangudi was a Nagaram, Pillayarpatti was a Nagaram, Iliathangudi was a Nagaram. So from these local Nagarams, the local products came to the market. As well as slightly to the north, there is a hill called Piranmalai. Piranmalai was a warehouse. It got goods from Kerala through Dindigul, it got goods from Gujarat, Karnataka through Salem, and it got goods from south of Kerala, Kanyakumari to Madurai and Piranmalai. So these goods that came into Piranmalai literally operated like a warehouse of a Walmart, where from the store, from the different stores or the different companies, goods come into a warehouse and gets redistributed into different centers. So same way, goods came in from different parts of India and as well as from the west end to Piranmalai, and goods came from southeast to Piranmalai and it was redistributed. The Erivirapattinam played a role as a exchanging market, or a market where inland goods were sold to traders who were ready to ship it out to southeast or to the west or to the north. So Erivirapattinam played an important role, as well as Nagarams played an important role. And there is one other organization called Manigramam. Manigramam were specialist in trading between west and east. So they got goods from Kerala, and there are inscription records in 7th century in Thailand which say that Manigramam had a colony in Thailand. So Manigramam was a very powerful organization. At around 1000 AD, they became subordinates to the Ainurvar. So the Ainurvar were the super organization which organized the logistics for all this trade involved. So it was the logistics supply chain arm of all these traders. So everybody accepted its rules. Manigramam also was a subordinate organization to Ainurvar, probably around 1000 AD. Manigramam was specialist in east-west trade. Ainurvar had specialties in moving the goods towards north, towards Karnataka and to north. So why I'm bringing all this into picture is that Ainurvar is a very famous group. our Mathur temple god, patron god, is called Ainutrishwara. So that is a direct reference that Mathur people of Mathur temple or the clans of Mathur temple had affiliation to the Ainu river. Then there are two Manigrama villages in near Chettinad. One is near Tirchi Urayur, other one is Kodumudi. So in Mathur, there is a clan called Urayur Udayar or Mathur Urayur. They possibly trace their origins to Urayur Manigrama. And there is Iliyathangudi Perumarudur Udayar, who trace their origins to Kodumbulur. Their Kuladevam today is Kodumbulur Murugan. So they have roots in Manigrama also. So we have roots from Manigramam, we had roots from Nagaram, we had roots from Ainurvar, as well as in each of the cities there were big streets or big market streets, Periyathiru. So Perundiru Vanigars, Palayar Koyil had a Perundiru, Iliyathangudi had a Perundiru. So there are also Perundiru merchants who are part of this geographical area. So eventually in the Vijayanagara period, around 1600 AD, all these different groups which settled in this local geographical area of current day Pudukkottai, Ramanathapuram and Sivagangai districts, and what is known as Chettinad today, became eventually known as a caste group known as Nattukottai Nagarathar. So it is 8 clans of people joining together and forming a temple, and different 8 clans of people joining together to form other temples, and so on. So 22 clans of Nattukottai Nagarathars were joined together to form what is known as our community today. So Iliyathangudi has 8 clans, Vairavan Koil has 3 clans, Mathur temple has 8 clans, and out of the 8 clans, one of the clans, Thiruvettur Udayar, they split from the Iliyathangudi and started 2 more temples, Pillayarpatti and Iraniyur. So if there are multiple clans within the temple, you will generally see that the temple has intermarriage within the same temple. But if it is a single clan temple like Ilpakudi or Nemam or Surakudi, you won't see intermarriages within the same temple. And also, though there are 2 different temples, Pillayarpatti and Iraniyur, they are from the same clan, so they don't intermarry with each other. So this is, our customs are generated because of the clans which join together to form this community. So out of these different, if you see the naming conventions of these different clans, they are called Ukkur Udayar, Marudur Udayar, Mannur Udayar. The Udayar here means people of. So people of Mannur, people of Manadur, people of Kannur, and so on. So if you see 80% of the names which occur in the 22 clans, they are actually from the Kaveri Delta region. That is, they are right on the shores of Kaveri River. So this itself shows that we have migrated from the Chola country into the current day Chettinad. So this Nagaram extended lot of, Nagaram, Ainurvar, Manigramam extended lot of power during the Chola period, around 12th century. There are, these trade groups have gone as an ambassador for the Chola kings to China. They have built a Shiva temple in China, which is still available in Quanzhou. So if you research on, if you do a Google search for Quanzhou temple, you can still see the Shiva temple built by these traders.